My name is Sunday, and I'm a cloud support engineer here at the AWS office in Dublin. Sometimes, customers ask me how they can enable audit logging for their Aurora MySQL database clusters to meet compliance requirements and also export these logs to CloudWatch for longer retention or to perform real-time data analysis. I tell them they can enable Aurora Advanced Audit into log-supported events such as connections, disconnections, queries, and so on. This can be achieved by setting the server audit login, server audit events, server audit exclude users, and server audit include users database cluster parameters in their custom parameter group. To publish these logs to CloudWatch, they can enable CloudWatch exports from the RDS console or the AWS CLI. Today, I'll be showing you how, so let's get started. First, we begin by logging into the AWS management console. Navigate to the RDS console. Select databases from the navigation pane. Select the Aurora MySQL database cluster where you want audit login to be enabled from the list. Navigate to the configuration tab and review the DB cluster details to see what parameter group is currently associated. When the cluster is created, it is associated with its default cluster parameter group. Because this parameter group can't be modified, you create a custom parameter group so you can make the necessary modifications. For this example, I already created and associated a custom parameter group with my test database cluster. Please refer to the following AWS documentation for the necessary steps to create and associate a custom parameter group for your database cluster. Select the custom parameter group. This takes us to another page where we can make the necessary modifications to enable audit logging. We will edit this cluster parameter group and add the necessary parameters to enable audit logging. The required parameters are server audit login, server audit events, server audit exclude users, and server audit include users, as I mentioned previously. The server audit login parameter is used to turn audit login on or off. Please set this parameter to 1. The server audit event parameter is used to specify what events to log. Please set this parameter to a combination of events. For my example, I'm going to set the connect and query event. Server audit exclude users. You can use this parameter to specify a list of users whose activity isn't logged. For my example, I am going to specify two database users I don't want login to be enabled for. User 1 and user 2. And lastly, server audit include users. You can use this parameter to specify a list of users whose activity will be logged. For this example, I'm going to specify the user 3 and user 4 in my database. When you finish making these modifications, save the changes. Please note, these parameters are dynamic and don't require a reboot of the Aurora MySQL database cluster if you already have a custom cluster parameter group associated. However, if you change the parameter group from a default to custom, you must perform a reboot for this new parameter group to be applied. After the logs are enabled, you can see the audit log files generated in the Logs and Events tab of the RDS console for the instance. For this example, you can see the logs have been generated here and here. Now, the next step is to enable CloudWatch exports. You can do this from the RDS console by modifying the database cluster and then selecting audit log from the log exports section. Please follow the steps. From the RDS console, select the Aurora MySQL database cluster that you want to enable CloudWatch exports for. Select Modify. Scroll down to the log export section and select audit log, and then choose continue. Confirm the changes and choose Modify Cluster on the summary page. Finally, to verify that these logs are being uploaded to CloudWatch Logs, from the database cluster, select the Configuration tab. You can see here the CloudWatch logs are being activated. Please note, it may take some time to activate. In the Published Log section, select Audit. This provides an output of the logs on the CloudWatch console. After completing these steps, your Aurora cluster begins sending events recorded in the audit logs to the CloudWatch logs, as you can see here.
Thanks for watching, and happy cloud computing from all of us here at AWS.